Hello everyone, I'm glad to introduce our paper titled Pixel Difference Networks for Efficient Edge Detection. We are from the University of Oulu, National University of Defense Technology, Harbin Institute of Technology, and Xidian University. My name is Zhuo Su. I'm a third year PhD student in University of Oulu, and my supervisor is Li Liu. I'm going to begin with a brief introduction of what edge detection looks like. For example, if we have the image of Lena, we would probably expect the edge detection algorithm or the edge detector to output like this or like this. Overall, the goal of edge detection is to identify image brightness changes, such as discontinuities in intensity, color, texture, depth, surface orientation, variations in illumination, etc. It has been a long-standing research topic in the computer vision community and benefits varies from low to high-level vision applications like salient object detection, super resolution, image segmentation, object detection, tracking and motion analysis, medical imaging, 3D reconstruction, and to some modern applications like autonomous driving. The approaches on edge detection evolved from the traditional edge detectors in early years, like Sobel, Privet, Laplacian of Gaussian, and Kenny, to later learning-based methods like structured forests, and finally in the deep learning era to the CNN-based methods. Traditional and learning-based methods usually encode image gradients as the basic features. For example, in the well-designed traditional operators, the differences between neighboring pixels are calculated to capture the gradient information, which is shown highly effective for edge detection. There is an explicit encoding for gradient information in their kernels. However, these methods suffer from the shallow structures being noisy sensitive and hard to achieve satisfactory performance in accuracy. From the other side, we look at the modern convolutional neural networks, which can automatically learn abstract and semantically meaningful features for high prediction accuracy. However, CNN kernels are usually initialized from random variables which approximately follow the Gaussian distribution and with no explicit encoding of gradient information during the training, making them hard to focus on edge-related features. What if we integrate the traditional operators with vanilla CNN convolution, or we name it as pixel difference convolution or PDC, what do we expect from PDC? Firstly, with the explicit encoding of gradient information, we can make the CNN model to focus on the features that facilitate edge detection. Secondly, the powerful learning ability of deep CNNs can still be preserved to extract semantically meaningful representations, which leads to robust and accurate edge detection. We give a quick view of the effect of pixel difference convolution as shown in the picture. The first row is feature maps generated by vanilla convolution. Well, we can see the object boundaries in many areas disappeared. Well, in the features of pixel difference convolution, we can safely preserve most of the detailed edge information, which is preferable for the final prediction. From the structure level, because of the lack of large-scale annotated data, the top-performing CNN-based detectors often use a pre-trained VGG net as a backbone, from which several task-specific branches are extended. Each branch will generate an edge map, and a corresponding loss will be calculated based on the edge map and the ground truth map. The model is often huge, mostly because of the big backbone, and it causes some issues. It is memory consuming, the model size is big, it is energy hungry for training and inference, and the labor consuming because they need big data to pre-train the backbone. We expect our model to have the following properties: small model size, high running efficiency, no need of big data for pre-training, and at the same time being accurate. Next, I will first introduce pixel difference convolution from the kernel level, and then I will give a brief illustration of our model architecture. Pixel difference convolution, or PDC, is pretty much similar to the vanilla convolution, and this is formulations of the two convolution operations. The only difference is that in PDC, instead of using the original pixel values, we use the value differences between pixels. If we have a 3x3 kernel in vanilla convolution, the 9 pixels in the local patch of the input feature map will be convolved with the kernel weight. But in PDC, we firstly select several pixel pairs from the local patch and calculate the pixel difference for each pair. Then we use the pixel differences to convolve with the kernel weight and generate the pixel in output feature map. Because there are numerous ways of selecting the pixel pairs, so we can actually create numerous PDC types, or we call PDC instances. For example, we show 3 PDC instances in the picture: CPDC, APDC, and RPDC. We are inspired from the traditional local binary pattern distributors. The 3 PDC instances are formed with different directions and are complementary for preserving the gradient information. In detail, take the APDC as an example. The convolution process is shown above. W1 times X1 minus X2 plus W2 times X2 minus X3 until the multiplication of W9. Someone may ask, do we need more computation for PDC compared with vanilla convolution? Actually, we can convert PDC to vanilla convolution with some simple mathematical transformations. Therefore, it doesn't introduce extra computation. Please refer to our paper for more detailed illustration if you are interested. For the model architecture, we follow the listed design principles to make the backbone as slim as possible and introduce functional task-specific branches for compensation. This is overall architecture of our model. Specifically, we have 4 stages in the backbone. Each stage has 4 blocks with shortcut, and the branch will be extended from the end of each stage. Inspired from MobileNet, we use a depth-wise convolution connected with a point-wise convolution to make the backbone small, and we adopt the proposed PDC in a depth-wise convolution. In the task-specific branches or the site structures, we use extra dilation convolutions with different receptive fields connected with a spatial attention module. And finally, each branch will generate an edge map. Again, please refer to our original paper for more details. Experiments are mostly on the BSDS 500 dataset, which has a training set with 200 images, a validation set with 100 images, and a test set with 200 images. Additionally, we will also use a VOC context dataset during the training. We train for 20 epochs if VOC is used and 14 epochs if it is not used with Adam optimizer and a PyTorch library. We firstly give some ablation studies on the backbone configuration. Because we have in total 16 blocks in the backbone, each block can use a PDC in its depth-wise convolution. The number of combinations is huge. Here, we empirically select some configuration alternatives by inserting different number of PDCs to the backbone. For example, in the table, CV15 means the first block use CPDC and the rest 15 blocks use the vanilla convolution. CVVV4 means for every 4 blocks, the first block use CPDC and the other 3 uses vanilla convolution, and it repeats for 4 times. We find the best configuration is CARV4, which means we use CPDC, APDC, RPDC, and the vanilla convolution in turn. And we name it as PDNet. For a further comparison between PDNet and the baseline, which only use vanilla convolutions, we give more experiments results by adjusting the number of channels in the backbone. It is constantly shown that PDNet is more effective than the baseline model. Next, we also do some explorations on the site structures by removing the dilation convolution module, the spatial attention module, and the shortcut. We find each of them takes a positive role in final performance. There are some visualizations of the site structure which also supports our conclusion. Finally, we give the performance comparison with previous state-of-the-art methods in terms of inference speed, model size, and accuracy. It can be seen that our model can achieve high running efficiency with very small model size, and at the same time achieve the same level of prediction accuracy among the recent CNN models. There is more for the precision recall curves and the quantitative comparison. To summarize, in this paper, firstly, we derive the pixel difference convolution which integrates the wisdom from the traditional edge detectors and the advantages of the deep CNNs, leading to robust and accurate edge detection. Second, we propose a highly efficient architecture named PDNet, based on pixel difference convolution, which are memory friendly and with high inference speed. Furthermore, PDNet can be trained from scratch only using limited data samples, while achieving state-of-the-art performance. For the future work, there were two aspects. For other applications, edge detection is a low-level task for many mid or high-level vision tasks like semantic segmentation and object detection. Also, some low-level tasks like salient object detection may also benefit from the image boundary information. We hope pixel difference convolution and the proposed PDNet can go further and be useful in these related tasks. For neural network search, like vanilla convolution, the proposed APDC, CPDC, and RPDC are even more by creating customer PDC instances can be regarded as a basic primitive convolution operations which can enrich the search space in NAS technology. We have also released our code and the trained models on GitHub. You're welcome to discuss with us if you are interested in our works. Thanks.